Hello, I am your new star attraction. I am a leafy sea BestInSlot. Gaze upon my wonders and despair. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is BestInSlot, and we are back playing Zoo Tycoon 2. And today we're going to do something a little bit different. We are going to start a free-form zoo. Nobody really seemed to care about the campaign. I didn't really care about the campaign. I just wanted to kind of introduce people back to Zoo Tycoon 2 without having to overload myself with mods. But you know what? This is a better way to do it. Our plan last season was to basically make lots of individual themed zoos, maybe have a break between each one, but the idea was that Zoo Tycoon 2 wouldn't be in seasons anymore, it would last forever. Maybe it would go away for a whole month, and then some new mods would come out, we'd get a new idea, and we'd come back and we'd make a cool zoo. That is really what I want to do. Now that we've got the new mod system in place, hopefully that will be much more possible than it was last season. And I should say, whilst we're on the topic of mods, if you do want to know what mods I'm using, you can check the description. Every single mod that I use is linked in the description down below, so you shouldn't need to keep asking me in the comments, basically. So what we're going to do to kickstart that, because I wanted to kind of get started with a freeform zoo, just make something a little cooler. We're not going to do anything too complex for this. It's probably only going to be a one or two episode zoo, just to lean into it. But we're going to mess around exclusively with the new creatures from the newly released Aurora Designs Complete Collection Pack, which adds 40 creatures to the game. We're only going to use those creatures, so we're going to see what they all are, and we'll go from there. Whilst we're doing this, I'd also like to talk to you guys, basically just what do you want to see? What types of zoos do you want created? Can we do a horror zoo? Can we do an alien zoo? Can we do a dinosaur, late Cretaceous specific zoo? Can we do, what I really want to do is like a proper aquarium, like a full-on aquarium zoo. That would be really cool. If you go down to sites like Zoo Tycoon 2 Roundtable, you'll find absolutely tons and tons and tons of mods there, so go check it out. Let me know in the comments down below, what kind of zoos do you want us to make in the coming episodes? Any ideas you got at all? Absolutely open to everything. I'm just going to set up a little introductory section here. It's not quite what I was going for there, but that will do. Don't know what that looks like. It's kind of like a magnetic strip kind of thing. And we just want to chuck some buildings on here, just as a nice... I don't really want to spend much time on the restrooms and stuff like that. I kind of want to focus on building some nice little exhibits. I don't really have any of the other mods installed in terms of things like building materials. You know, there's a lot of very cool building materials we're going to get our hands on as I go download some mods in the next few videos. Oh, shish kebab. Yes, always the time for a shish kebab. Oh, no, 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 no. I'll just go back and have a burger. I'm trying to keep a theme going here. And I need a coffee stand. Nothing better than on a hot day is a hot covered Joe. Ooh, there we go. That looks normal. That looks fine. It's whatever. It's who cares? It's coffee. But yeah, just let me know in the comments down below. Check the downloads on all these sites and what theme zoos do you want to see? And that's what we're going to focus on for the rest of our time playing Zoo Tycoon 2. So let's get started and build our first exhibit. Let's click on animals and see what we're playing with. To be honest, guys, my original plan was to do another episode specifically into the campaign. But it kept crashing. I'm hoping the reason it was crashing was just an issue with the campaign mission and not something to do with my game in general. Right, here we have all the Aurora design things. And there's one animal in particular I know is in this collection. I think is in this collection. I'm pretty sure I saw it linked. And I'm pretty sure I saw a sloth. I'm going to be very upset if I've been misled by my own head. Oh, is that what I meant about a three-toed sloth? Okay, we have to kick things off with a three-toed sloth. Imagine you walk through a zoo, the first thing you see is a three-toed sloth. It's a terrible idea if you think about it, because the only way from there is down, you know? It can't get any better than a three-toed sloth, so, you know, you've kind of set yourself up for danger there, haven't you, really? Wooden pen fence. That's quite nice, isn't it? That suits the environment. I'm going to make this quite small. I need you to be able to actually see the sloth. That's probably too small. It's probably too small. It's probably not too small in reality. It's probably is too small for the sloth to be happy. And it's a sloth, so I want him to be happy. We can always make it a little bit bigger if need be. All I want is like the slothiest trees I can find. I think that one might be the slothiest. You know what I mean by the slothiest tree. I don't have to explain that, right? My combi patch still isn't working. I can't stack trees. I'm going to fix that as well. But yeah, if you do want... Oopsie daisy. If you do want any mods, they are all linked down below. The sites are linked. I've described exactly where on the site they are, all that kind of jazz. I've made it super, super easy for you guys to download any of the mods I'm using. So, I want to hear no more about it, okay? Yeah, I really need combi patch. This is upsetting me. Oh, look up. Oh, yeah, let's stick that in. That's awesome. I've got my big rocks back. Oh, this is so cool. Big rocks. Shelters, you don't need a shelter. Got that. You do need a little bit of food. And a little bit of water. Just kind of said those won't go around. Let's just rotate a little bit because we've got this whole space over here that I'm kind of neglecting. And put another couple of ferns in. Oh, what's this? Yeah, that looks okay. That's pretty cool. Stick some of those in. What's this? I want all these things. Some flowers. Might have missed Combi Patch. For those who don't know, because I'm going to reference it a lot, Combi Patch basically lets you put things on top of other things. It lets you stack flowers and stuff together. It's a really cool little mod, which I do have installed. I just haven't installed correctly, apparently. I don't know how you even do that. Ooh, I like that as well. Do I like this fence? No, I do like this. It's perfect. Chinese fence. Got some cool stuff. Right, but what I'm actually looking for is the gate. There it is. There we go. Lovely jubbly. And let's get ourselves... No. Okay, we're going to hold off just a little bit. I'm going to set up two... Ooh, what is that? Oh, I've set my... Oh, these are cool. Little Aurora Design Chinese food stands. That's awesome. Anyways. I really like this path as well. There's a couple pretty cool... Ooh, that might be better. Wooden tile path. We can do a Chinese zoo! Oh, we're totally going to do a Chinese zoo. That'll be awesome. So I need to make sure this zoo isn't too Chinese. Because my next zoo will be more Chinese. It will be the most Chinese of any zoo you've ever seen. I am also going to save the game. Because I'm a little paranoid still. Hopefully one day I won't have to be paranoid anymore. But for now, still pretty paranoid. Okay, so what we should do... I was about to say we should find some animals that want to go together so we can do like a little... Oh, it's a platypus! I really want a platypus. Is there anyone else who wants to live in temperate forest? A padamelon, but it's tiny. I want like a decent sized creature, I think. What's this? A nilgay. Mustang. Oops, a couple of moras that we've actually seen already. Lemurs. Iguanas. We're definitely going to do a little iguana thing. There's a lot of small creatures and not very many big, cool creatures. They're all very well made, though. Great Barracuda. Bontebok. Barowl. What do we want? What do we want? I'm only going to use these. Indian Rhino. There we go. Got my big creature. And this lives in Tropical Savannah. Right, so let's see if there's anything else in this mod that lives in Tropical Savannah that I could then combine with my little lovely rhino. Or we could do these two together. Goats and Hyrax. The Hyraxes are adorable, so I'd kind of like to include those as well. What was that? Oh, there we go. Cool. Okay, so we'll do a little rhino exhibit as well. I say a little rhino exhibit. It's a rhino, so it's going to be a fairly big exhibit. Apparently, they can't use this little weak chain link fence. God knows why, right? Crazy. Brick wall? Low brick wall? Actually, it doesn't look any safer than that, but apparently it's good enough, so let's roll with that. We're going to make this a little bit bigger, because it's a rhino. Rhinos are fairly large all the way over here. So obviously, design-wise, we're not really going for much this season. Not this season, but on this zoo. It's just kind of like a, you know, let's get back playing Zoo Tycoon 2. Let's get back doing what we wanted to do in the first place. That's kind of the whole shebang here. Blah. Get a bit of Tropical Savannah on the go. So you got to roll it off your tongue like you got molasses in your throat, you know? According to The Office, anyway. It's literally the only reason I'm making that specific sound. Oh. Do I like that? I don't know. I made a penis. Yeah, that'll do. I mean, his penis is goat. It's a nice one. It's a bit bendy for my liking, but I don't really have much of a preference for penises. Don't know what I'm saying. We're going to move on with our lives. So nice being able to just make big-ass exhibits again, you know? It's honestly, it's really nice after having been restricted so recently by the campaign mode. Oh yeah, definitely nothing fancy so far. We're going to save that for the next few episodes. This is more just an introduction back into what we're doing for Zoo Tycoon 2. That's kind of the idea. We want to top it? Let's go top it. We can do whatever the hell we like. Little bushes down. Bit of texture in there, you know? Put a shelter at the back? Yeah, why not? Probably need another tree over there. Like a little one? Yeah. Okay. And food. Food dish with branches. Water dish. Just stack on top of each other, you nerds. And that should be it. Now we need to check quickly what the other little dude wants. Who is the little dude? Is it this dude? Shavanna. It's the Dweka. Oh, wait, no, it wasn't. It was this dude. It's actually the same dude we had last time. And does seem to eat the same stuff. And have the same stuff there. Cool. Right. Oops. Wait, no, I don't want a plant, I want an animal. Okay, we're gonna need a few of these because... Okay. Where's my right? Oh, what is that? Indo-Chinese green peafowl. Also, leafy sea dragon. Tiny! We can make like a little aquarium thing. That'd be awesome. Couple of rhinos. Lovely jubbly. Where's my sloth? Couple of sloths. Lovely jubbly. Right, I'm gonna open the zoo. It's apparently... Oh, it is open. Oh, nobody comes in until you've got animals, that's why. Let's get ourselves a zookeeper. Two, why not? Oh, no! Oh, yeah, just because other people are eating it. Basically. You can get there fine, stop being soft. They might need more water, considering there's two massive rhinos in here. I'm going to plant a few of these knocking around, and a few food dishes as well. Just in case. Don't really want rampaging rhinos on my first day of the job. Right. So this... Hey. Hey! First day of our new zoo. No. Okay, little sloth exhibit. Can't see the sloths because they're tiny and they're sloths. I think there's one drinking from the water bowl. I see a little brown thing. We'll come back here in a second. Let's go check on our other guys. Didn't put a gate into this one, did I? Nope. Hip, hop the fence. Nope. Okay, let's put a gate in. Let's do this somewhat logically. Little staff gate there. Hop back in. Hello, beautiful. It's really cool, isn't it? The texture, the design, everything about the rhino. And that's why I wanted a bigger creature, because you can really see the work they put in. I mean, the little guys look great, but because they're so small, it's hard. Hey! Hey! None of that malarkey, you leathery little son of a gun. It's like, right, on World of Warcraft, which I still play for God knows what reason, my character, for a long time, was a gnome, and she will be a gnome once again. Yes, a female gnome. Yes. Shut up, don't judge me. But the problem with gnomes is you don't see the armor that well. And that's despite World of Warcraft armor not being that well textured or anything. So imagine like if it looked like this, which is like really beautifully well made. Imagine if this rhino was the size of a sloth. You wouldn't see all these lovely folds. And they are lovely. They're really good. I've never been so excited about skin flaps before. But you little rhino, you've done it. You've made me excited about skin flaps. Okay. Good stuff. And you're adorable. You're going to live in here, okay? Is that okay? Yeah, that's probably fine. You are far too young to be getting a hot cup of coffee. What are the prices? Okay, can we tell what any of those things say? Fat bonnet. Adios, pig. Hawk licks menstru. No, let's not go there. God knows what that top one's gonna be. And that second one's $7. Bloody you. Also, I love that you can hear all these noises and like coffee being poured and stuff, yet they're just standing there glaring into your soul effectively. What's that noise? Oh, it's a sleeping rhino. Okay, let's go meet the sloths. Hello, cutie. Okay, you're very hard to see because you're very small. Don't worry, buddy, I got it. Look at this flower. It's like a bird of paradise kind of thing. I'm going to save it very quickly, but we're going to hop back. We're going to go into photo mode, and hopefully that's going to let us get a better view of the sloth. Where the hell is my cat? There it is. Yeah! Ah! I have to do it like that, right? It's really hard to take screenshots on this game sometimes of the small creatures. I've tried, believe me. Little slothy, come here. Come. I'm stuck on your house. I'm out of film. Oh no. Well, we had a good run, Mr. Sloth. We had a good run. I need a way to zoom in whilst I'm down here. What's this? Oh yeah, yeah. I want him to climb the thing. Go, do it. Look at it, it's beautiful. I'd climb it if I was a sloth. And you are a sloth. You have no, he's going for it. He's totally going for it. It's gonna take him about half an hour to get there, but I'm excited. Come on, buddy. Go on. Yeah! Kind of just flying up it, if we're honest, but... awesome. Look at the happy little sloth. Up he goes. I don't know why that's so entertaining for me. But it really is. He's adorable. He made it all the way to the top, and I'm very proud of him. Okay. Let's just make a couple more random exhibits. Really, the point of this episode, more than anything, is to kind of showcase the mod. This is one of the mods along with basically everything linked in this video as of today. I mean, the document is going to update, but the Aurora Design stuff, both the replacements for the old stuff that's already in the game, and their 40 new creatures, the combi patch stuff, and most of the building stuff, that's going to stay in the game. Everything else is the stuff that's going to rotate out, and that's going to be given sort of themes and stuff like that. Right, what else have we got? I kind of want to do something with the sawfish, because it's a sawfish, and that's pretty cool. However, I also want to do something with the leafy sea dragon. Right, what we should do is make a really small tank. Like a teeny tiny baby tank. How do we do that? Tank. Okay. I think that's the smallest it'll go. Although, is it? Oh, what's this? What have I done? Ugh, stop. Give me a minute. I'm trying to remember how I change. Ah, that. I couldn't see that button right there, basically. Right, I want this to be... There we go. Right, tell you what, I'll be nice, I'll give it a longer one. Only slightly. These bloody sea dragons. Tell you what, they don't know they've been bloody born. Get rid of that little divider there, and I want to knock this right down. Not that far, but about there maybe. It should be like a little tank that you can walk up to. I'd like to be able to put it onto a table. I think the only way to do that would be to put it onto an elevated path, maybe? It's about the only way I can think of. Right, so let's set the biome. Boop! Lovely. I don't know if this is going to work. And it should, look at the size of the dude, you know? It should be fine. But whether it is or not is a whole other kettle of fish. I'm going to put some plants at the bottom, I think. It's hard to tell. Yeah, that's probably a little bit big for you, buddy. I'm going to stick you in there, and you're going to love it and not complain, okay? Yeah? Sounds like a plan. Thanks. Look at the little leafy sea dragons just chilling about. Cool. And they're not complaining. How nice is it when things don't complain? Oh, look at that chimp. Right, I'm just going to put the chimp down for a second. Because I'm terrified of it. Wait, no. Yeah. Look at it. It's already trying to go on a murderous rampage. Look at it. Look at the teeth. Whoa. I didn't realize the zookeepers actually did that. I thought it was shooting the little... poor little bugger. Go away. Alright. My chimp has been adopted. Look at this. This aquarium is awesome. I should do more of this. I do love the idea of having like a full-on, basically, let's make SeaWorld. You know, have little aquariums like this, have touch pools where you got really, really shallow water on really low things, so you can go around and touch the starfish and the rays and stuff like that, and then have big exhibits and have a central tower one, and have a reptile house, because they always have reptile houses for some reason, because some reptiles like water, I guess. Have dolphin shows and stuff like that. I just think you can do some really cool stuff. I want to go in here. Bloop. Hello. Oh. Okay, this is quite hard to navigate in. Leafy sea dragon. Oh, I can't go any closer. Hello, I am your new star attraction. I am a leafy sea BestInSlot. Gaze upon my wonders and despair. Oh, this is kind of creepy. Oh, I don't know if I like this. Also, the dragons are smaller than the fish by a fairly substantial... Alright, calm down. Da-da-da-da. Da-da-da-da. Oh, I kind of love that. That's amazing. Sick. Just in case. Never be too careful, folks. Never be too careful. Okay, we need to make one more exhibit to finish things off in style. I think it's going to have to be a platypus. Because everybody loves a platypus. Everybody. Listen to me, folks. Everybody loves a platypus. So, where's my platypus? Oh, but he's really... They're all so cute. They've really focused on small, cute, cuddly creatures, and it's making it very difficult to decide which ones to basically ignore. The main dwarf isn't providing that difficulty just because he's sitting there flashing me. Okay. What fence do we want? Preferably the ones I've already... I'm just going to use this one and assume it's fine. Right? Yeah. What's the worst that could happen? Exactly. Oh, no, I didn't notice the children somehow. Children? We're trying to make a platypus exhibit. Are you a platypus? No! Get out then! Nerds. Again, this should be quite a small exhibit, I think. I'm thinking, like, about this big? It should not be humongous. It's a problem I often have. Oh, temperate forest. Awesome. I want it to be mainly water. The problem with that is the exhibit is so small already, it's going to be quite difficult to fit anything in. But we need a tree! It's quite fun in a way, mini exhibits, because you kind of have to... I don't know, you have to be a little bit more inventive, I guess, with how you get your design in to make these little slices of life, you know? Which tends to be how I design, in general. I don't like any of these. Have some ferns instead. A couple of rocks. No, little rocks there. Okay. This might be the issue. I think these are a bit too small to put food in. Oh, it needs deep food. Deep water, okay, well. Okay, I think we have to extend the exhibit out. Just a little bit. Just like one in this direction, basically. And let's put some deep water all the way along there. Lovely jubbly. Is that enough? How can it be too shallow? There we go! Took some effort, but we got there. Okay. Is this going to be okay? This looks like it's okay. Platypus! Oh, finally I can see in the water. I don't know why that wasn't working. Platypi! Platypodes! Platypopidodes! All these scientific words I'm throwing at you guys. Right. Boop! I really like this idea. I'd like the bottom of the tank to be much higher than it currently is. We can change that, though. We can change that. I didn't think about that at the time, but that's actually a really good point. Well done, me. So we want to grab... I just want to grab it at all, if humanly possible. Come here! Stop it. No. Can I just grab it from here? No, I need to go into this. Don't know why I was trying to grab it. I should have been going onto this. And raise tank floor. Right, that's the size it goes. Better. It's not good enough, but it's better. Now I can stare at people from across the way. Then we go over here and we see... Oh god, this is filthy! Filthy! Just because I don't have bins or cleaners, it's no excuse to litter like this. What the hell? Also, why are you having coffee in a water bottle, you freaks? Rhinos, gorge them for me. Gorge them all. Oh my god, I was just here! How are you this filthy? You, child, I'm watching you. I like that when they first put down the trash, it doesn't actually appear. So if you highlight the child, it kind of, the thing appears around them and it says, press spacebar to take out the trash. Meaning the child. How? Oh. That is going to give someone serious epileptic shock. I don't think I'm not watching you. I'm just going to go see my platypus. Bear with me. Bear with me. Oh, he's so cute. Look at him. They're like little happy dolphins. Oh, it's actually adorable. I think they're struggling with the lack of deep water. I really didn't think they'd want deep water. Like, from my own personal experience with platypuses, I thought they'd prefer shallow water. It doesn't seem to be the case at all, so... Let me in. Let me inside you, for God's sake. There we go, that's more like it. You dead. You look dead. Are you asleep in the water? That seems... Oh, you're cleaning yourself, I think. Don't quill me, bro. A happy little platypus. It's cool, right? Okay. Well, this was a little look at Aurora Designs. We probably won't come back to this, but really that's up to you guys in the comments down below. Either way, we're going to let this sit for a little bit. I'm going to start gathering my mod collection, and then we're going to start making some really cool zoos. The game hasn't crashed in 26 minutes, which is making me optimistic that there's a problem with the campaign of some form, rather than the game itself. Because frankly, I don't have that many mods installed at all right now. I definitely don't have enough that would break the game. So, hopefully that is all that is. Hopefully that is all that is. Wow. English language is weird. But yeah, so let me know in the comments down below what you would like to see, what types of zoos do you want to see, and if you see someone else who has the same kind of idea, make sure you upvote that comment. Better chance I'll see it, although I will try to read all of them anyway. And I will come up with some of my own ideas. I'm going to look out for some cool mods. If you do see particular creatures you want me to download on sites like Zoo Tycoon 2 Roundtable, link those down below in the description and I can directly download those. It's going to be a lot of work over the next week or so, just trying to collect them all and group them all and organize all the mods and stuff. But by the end, we should be ready to make some very cool zoos. Hope you guys are as excited as I am. Thank you for joining me. I shall see you lovely folks in the next episode. Cheers, much love, and as always, bye-bye.